Hello, my name is Jean Quintus, and I am publishing a new fly every month on my website www.meckejang.lu. You see it there.
The fly of the month of July 2015 is an upside down Paraloop blue wing olive. To tie this fly, we will use a Tiemco 100 or Kamazan B400 in size 10 up to 14, a black medium tying thread. The tail will be made with spinner tails. For the Paraloop, we'll use an horsehair and a brown cock feather. The body will be made with a peacock curl. For the wings, we will use one white CDC feather, and the thorax will be made with a fine black dubbing. We will tie in the thread at the eye of the hook and wind it in closed turns backwards to the beginning of the curvature of the hook. Here we will cut off the excess of tying thread and wind a little thickening to help us split the spinner tails at the next stage. We will tie in two spinner tails at the middle of the hook shank. Keep them on both sides of the hook shank and wind the thread backwards to that little thickening that we have tied previously. Then we can cut the excess of the spinner tails. Then we will tie in underneath the hook shank the horsehair. We will fix it with a few turns. Then we will tie in the peacock curl and secure it with our tying thread to a point just behind the horsehair. We will fix the horsehair in the gallows of our tying vise. And then tie in the brown cock feather in front of the Paraloop post. And with one turn, we will bring the tying thread behind the Paraloop post. Then we will wind the cock feather along the horsehair upwards. With the help of the dubbing needle, it will be easier to bring the cock feather around the point of the hook. When we have created a long enough hackle around the horsehair, the distance should be approximately the length between this post and the eye of the hook. At that point, we will wind the feather backwards to the shank of the hook. When we arrive at the shank of the hook, we will tie off the cock feather by winding one or two turns around the horsehair and the feather to secure it. And we will cut off the excess of the feather. Now we can wind the peacock curl at the rear side of the paraloop two or three turns, and then we will wind it forward in direction of the eye of the hook. Wind the tying thread through the peacock curl to the front to secure the peacock hull. Cut off the excess of the peacock hull. Then we are going to take the CDC feather, strip back all feather tips, and tie it in as shown here. When the feather is secured, we will cut off the excess of the feather.
David, the bard on his bed of death lies, pale are his features and dim are his eyes, yet all around him his glance wildly.
And then we will create the two wings by peeling off the first free feather tip above the tied in feather tips from the quill of the feather. So we peel off the first free feather tip from the quill of the feather. By doing this, we remove the wing from the quill. Then we can cut off the quill of the feather and cut off the two feather tips that we have used to peel off the wings from the quill. With this method, we have created two identical wings for our fly. To lift them up a little bit, we'll wind one or two turns of thread behind the wings. Then we will twist some black dubbing onto our tying thread to make the thorax of our fly. We will first wind one or two turns behind the wings. Retwist the dubbing. Add another turn. And then wind another turn or two in front of the wings. Then we flip the horsehair to the eye of the hook. Tie it in. By pulling on the horsehair, we will bring the Paraloop to the front, to the eye of the hook. Cut off the horsehair. Wind the head and whip finish.
Often the hearts of our chiefs it has stirred when its loud summons to battle was heard. Harp of my country, dear harp of
you can download the detailed tying instructions for this fly and for all the previous ones on my website www.meckejang.lu. Leave a message in the guest book with your email address and I will send you a mail every time a new fly is published. See you and tight lines!